Got yesterday.
Hey, this is Ben here at vendorsunited.com and hotdogcartstar.com. And I thought for whatever reason I got my time mixed up today, and I was telling you we had 7 minutes and 12 minutes left before we went live with Candace and Dale, her husband. And it turns out it was actually it's 4 o'clock Central Time and 5 o'clock Eastern. I'm on Eastern and they're on Central. And so we already know what's going to happen in the future because we're an hour ahead of them. And so, but I have Candace and Dale with me, and let me pull y'all in, and hopefully everybody see you. If you can see us, let me know you can see both of us, as far as all three of us on the screen.
All right.
Let me know in the comments. I'm talking to them, Candace. I'm asking them if they can see us. We've got several people in here right now. Yep. Hello, Ben, Daru, Anthony, David. Hey, let me know if we have, can y'all see us good? All right. I'm hoping. Yeah. David says no, can't see him. Here. I'm gonna see if I can split it this way. How about now? Can you see us? All right. You'll see me look down because I got a screen down here, I got a screen right here, and I got a screen right here. This screen, though, I can't have activated for this, so I have to look down at my notes. Well, I have Candace and Dale, and their last name is Beard, like Beard, right? And and y'all are out of Oklahoma, right?
Arkansas.
That's even better than Oklahoma, okay? It didn't have they don't have an Arkansas the musical, but it is a prettier place. I've been there. I love Arkansas. I saw my first tarantula in Arkansas.
Yeah.
I did.
Yeah, I believe it.
Yeah. I went camping up there in the y'all have mountains, and there was like tarantulas. And the guide told us that's tarantulas, and I thought they came from like South America or something. He goes, no, we have them here. And I'm talking big tarantulas.
Yep. Saucer.
Yeah. Yep. So, now let's talk about this because y'all haven't started yet. Y'all are just getting started. Right. And y'all are making in the planning stages, and hopefully we can have you back on as you progress through this and get to the point you want to be. My favorite point is freedom and success. And so tell me a little bit about what y'all done in the past and what your goal is with this.
All right. Well, I personally have had over 20 years experience in the restaurant area. I've done everything from dishwashing to waiting on tables to managing to owning a bakery / donut shop. And I love to cook. And we currently have, my husband has a floor service business where I work with him now stripping and waxing floors. And then we have the buffing contracts. But
so I have restaurant experience as well, keeping their floors shiny.
I have restaurant experience from eating at them.
Okay. So we just decided that we wanted to get out of the floor service business. We've tried several other things, and we just decided that our heart is in doing this. And people want to eat, so we want to serve them. And we've been to some food truck festivals. It's really weird because we can't see you. All we're looking at is a blank screen. So
that is odd. I don't know why it's not letting you see me on, because you have the same screen I'm seeing as far as the same platform. We both get the same copy of the same link.
Yeah.
For this platform. So I may have to look into something different, but I was trying it.
Okay. We went to some food truck festivals and tried some of the food and realized that I could definitely do so much better. And some of the foods took long to serve, and we were trying to rack our brains as to what we could do that would be quick to get out the window and make money at and make people happy, but be unique all at the same time. And what our goal is to have a cannoli truck.
Right.
Where I make...
homemade cannolis?
Well, yes. There is a place where we can purchase the shells already made, and then I just make the different fillings. And not just dessert cannolis, but I've got some savory, like a buffalo chicken cannoli and a taco-type cannoli. And all I've got a whole menu I've been putting together, and we've tried it, a lot of the recipes and some of the dessert cannolis as well. And this Christmas, we bought a case of cannoli shells, and I made the ones that I had already come up with recipes for and tried it out on our families, and they loved them. So they'll be easy to do, get out the window fast. The profit is good, but we can't afford to get into a trailer right now. Financially, we're not quite where you were when you got started, but we're skating there. So we want to do better.
It is scary, especially, you know, I have found that many of the people that are my age and older are looking for either ways to supplement their income or that something other than a J-O-B type thing, whether it's 40 hours a week, $9.50 an hour, and you have no life because you've worked all your life. And what we have found is that majority of our customers fit that age range. And the nice part is you got people like that have gone before us. You know, I've talked about standing on the shoulders of giants. You know, I've talked about standing on the shoulders of giants, and there you are. You get to being powered and uplifted by their knowledge, the people that have gone before us. You know, I've learned a lot from other people. And then still I learn. There's people like Michael Wood and Corey and Jason and Rick and John and Sandra. There's a lot of people out there that have helped me learn more. I was talking to a 19-year-old vendor in Australia last night. Had to do it late because it was when he could do it, you know, because they're on a different, way different time. They ain't an hour difference from us, by the way. And
yeah.
I was speaking to him. And he was telling me stuff he was doing that was blowing my mind at 19. And I'm going, holy cow, I wish I'd have had your brain at 19. So there's a lot to go. So y'all's goal, Dale and Candace, your goal is to get a concession trailer, truck, or something that you're inside so that you can do cannolis. And is your goal to cater with that stuff, or is it to... is it more to street food vending, street roadside stuff or events?
Probably more to do street food, roadside stuff. If the door opened for catering and it looked like that would be a good venue, we would look into it.
There's a lot of events in this area though that we're interested in doing events as well.
Yeah.
And possibly catering down the road, but we're not going to start with that.
We don't want to work 60, 70 hours a week.
No, I don't know many people that do work that much. In the furniture industry, I used to work, you know, 70, 80 hours a week. And I had these huge dark circles under my eyes and unhealthy. Well, even though I was making plenty of money, I had no time for family and no time for friends, no time for kids. It was nothing. So the benefit of this is if you look for the locations, make good records as you go, take good records, you will be able to narrow it down. You know, Corey's talked about this before, and I think he's here with us. He is here with us. And you'll be able to narrow it down to the days and times, the best times to work. And you might find, here's how crucial this is. You might find that Tuesdays are better than any other day. I'm just throwing something random. But the first and second Tuesday of the month aren't as good as the third and fourth Tuesday of the month. And you start narrowing it down and you start going, well, you know what? We don't really have to open on that Tuesday. We could go to another location. I will tell you, catering, I know that's not on your mind at first, but it's not what you think. Catering is so much better than what, for vendors, it's so much better than the restaurant type catering you hear. And there's a lot of money to be made with it and less time. Jason, pretty much all he does, Michael Wood with Doug's Dogs, it took me 3 years to get him to finally do catering. And now he's booked all the way, I think, through September.
Wow.
And he's spending less time. And because he has a set amount he's going to get when he goes, he knows he's going to get it, period, rain or shine. And so he's cutting down on these things to do this. And it took me 3 years to twist his arm into doing it, but he's doing it. And we have, I mean, there's literally thousands of vendors that are doing that now. So are you going to expand in other foods? So if I understood you right, y'all are going to start out with cannolis.
Right.
There's a blue million types of cannolis.
Yes.
Are you going to carry a wide variety? And are you going to offer like fresh squeezed lemonade? Or are you going to do any like breakfast cannolis and do coffee?
We have thought about the coffee and breakfast cannolis. Right now, it's more along the lines of lunch and dinner. We also had thought about serving other things aside from cannolis, so it would be cannolis and more. So that's where the hot dogs come in.
Okay.
And also, we have a good homemade cheese dip, and cheese dip is really big here in Arkansas. It's actually his dad's recipe, who's passed away. So that and chips. That's about it. As far as the different types of cannoli, I don't want to get into having like 12 or 15 different kinds, because that is just too much to have as far as inventory on the truck. I want to narrow it down to maybe 6 to 8 different types, with maybe 5 of those being dinner or lunch type, the savory type, and then maybe 3 or 4 of those being a dessert type.
Oh, yeah, that's a great idea. I didn't even think about dessert cannolis.
Yeah.
Because I've had cream cheese and chocolate cannolis, but it just never, when you say cannoli, I'm thinking just, the more of the dinner type.
They don't serve those here. That's right. An open field here in Arkansas.
A lot of people in Arkansas don't even know what a cannoli is. So it's going to be a new experience for
them. I'm familiar with the original Italian cannolis, the dessert cannolis. That I lived in New Jersey for 11 years, and so I love cannolis. I met an Italian couple years ago, 30, 40 years ago, who gave me their grandmother's recipe for the dessert cannoli. So it's an original old Italian recipe, and it's really good. So that's going to be one of them. But then, I've got some other ideas for a few other different types of desserts. But the rest of them are mostly going to be the savory type.
Okay. And what do you think your timeline is right now for getting going?
Yeah, we don't have one.
No, I like honesty. And people can relate to honesty better than they can anything else to me. Then let me ask you this then, because obviously there's stumbling blocks or something in between there and this. Typically that comes down to money.
Yep.
So what has been your biggest challenge so far, or stumbling block or wall you have to cross before you can get going?
The money. We found some trailers that we like, but we went for financing at one place, and it just would have cost us almost 3 times as much by the time we were through. And we're not going to do that. We're not going to get ourselves into debt. So yeah, the financing is what is our biggest stumbling block.
Well, I agree with you there. I preach against not financing unless it's I have to. It's a good feeling going in. I'd rather owe my mother-in-law money than owe a bank money. Not because I know that, you know, she isn't going to sue me. It's just the weight of the debt mentally is heavier when I think about owing some bank or somebody money that I don't know. But
maybe we could owe your mother-in-law.
So what have y'all considered building your own cart, or have you considered getting a cart to start out with? Or Arkansas's not bad with the health department codes, so could you start out with a pop-up tent and a setup? I did an article and I showed a guy that made $800 his first day. He took my course, the instant vendor course, and his first day did $800 with no equipment. He used household type equipment on pop-up tables, and he borrowed the tables from a church.
Yeah. We definitely have considered that. I have a trailer that, I used to use when I was in the arts and crafts. I mean, I've toyed in just about everything, but it's a pretty decent sized trailer that is just for hauling. How do you describe that trailer? But we thought about taking and building like a hot dog trailer out of it, or some type of concession trailer out of it. But it's not one that you can walk into and be covered. And the thing about this area too is that I have not been able to locate any commissaries. And we live out in the country and we have well water and we have four dogs, so cooking out of our house would not work as far as the health department is, I think.
Well, no, there's some rules though, and I don't know, Candace, if y'all have my course, the instant vendor course.
No, we don't.
Okay. You may want to get that. And to be perfectly honest, it's less than $10. I announced it today on the show before this one, today at 3:30. And I give you a bonus, a new course that nobody knows about yet. You get it before anybody, and it's free.
Okay.
And it'll be for sale later, but the instant vendor course is going to show you how to do what you want to do without waiting till you have $5,000 or $3,000 or $10,000 or whatever it is to get started. This will get you started within a day or two legally. I show you all the tips and tricks I've learned over the years. And I'm tooting my own horn a bit here, but last year I did a little over 1,600 vendors got started with that course. Now they paid $197 for it, and I've got it just right now in a limited time for less than 10, but it allowed them to over 1,600 vendors start last year with little to no money. And I'm talking less than the most that I got an email on, because I send them emails out and ask them how much, you know, what did it take you to get started? I want to hear your feedback. What'd you think? You know, which of my tactics did you use? And the most I heard about was around $600. Wow. And these are people, there's a guy in North Carolina, right across the mountain from me, an older gentleman, hurt his back. Long story short, he set up with his granddaughter, and in one day, blew my mind. He called me and he's crying. And if you saw this guy, he's a big, burly man. And he was in tears because this stuff works. I'm not just saying it sometimes works. If you just pick one of these things, this may be not what you want to do forever, but it may be your stepping stone to getting that trailer. It certainly will make you money. So whether you spend that money on paying bills or investing in a trailer or building your own or setting up a tent system, I give you all kinds of cool things. There's a lot of cool things in there that you'll go, what? I didn't know I could do that. And yes, even in Arkansas. So you won't have to worry about that. So that's what I would suggest. I wouldn't suggest One, I wouldn't suggest putting off anything. And two, I wouldn't suggest spending money that you're not comfortable spending. So if you're not comfortable doing it, it puts a lot of weight on your shoulders to go out there and start vending. And you've got this $12,000 debt, which feels like a behemoth on your back.
Yeah.
I borrowed $500 from my mother-in-law after I sold two kidneys and, you know, everything else. I'm exaggerating, but I did borrow $500 after I sold everything that wasn't nailed down. And it, even that $500 bugged me, but I got her paid back within 11 days. 11 days of starting, I paid her back. So, within 7 weeks, I had bought two more carts with the profits off the first cart. And I don't know how big a town you're in, Candace and Dale, but I'm in Podunkville. I mean, I'm in a little town. And so probably similar, you know, Arkansas doesn't have a whole bunch of big cities.
Right.
I mean, it's got a couple, I know, but what I'm saying is that it's not like, you know, New York. I think what your ideas are great. I think that there's some stuff that you'll get out of that will blow your mind. I mean, literally you'll go, holy cow. I'd grab it. In fact, I'll do this for you. When this is over, I'm going to send you, I'll email you, Candace. I have your email and you're already a member of the Vendors United Street Food Pro Team. I'm going to send you the course for free. Grab it. Okay. Grab it and y'all read through it, look at it and go, hey, I'm going to change this. I'm going to fix this. I'm going to, pick one of the things. Cause I do multiple things in there and some of them can work together, but you might go, oh, I like C. I like item C. I like, that's going to work for us. And that'll work with our cannolis. It's going to open your mind, I promise. And I know I'm tooting my own horn, but I was excited when I put that out and it's helped so many people. It's my biggest source right now. Happy, make me get a big head, ego building emails I get.
That's every cool. Week.
So how to help you. Do you have any questions for me while we're on here? John asked, does Candace have a trailer or cart? And no, she's not started, John. John got in here late. John's the vendor of the week, by the way, over at the main page. He's in Idaho Falls, Idaho. He's kicking butt. He does bars, I think, three nights a week, if I remember right. But, Candace, is there anything you that y'all would like to share with anybody, or do you have any questions I can answer for you?
I know that, and this is probably in your course, but I know that we are required to have hand washing sinks. How do you get by with that if you set up just tables and things? And if I prepare all of the food here, then, well, it's probably all in your course, right?
It is, but here's the cool thing. And I'll go ahead and answer this. A hand washing sink, if I believe Arkansas is just a hand washing sink. They don't require you to have a three bay. They will require you to have a commissary,
okay.
Which I got tons of free stuff on how to get a commissary free. Cool. But over at learnhotdogs.com. But you have a hand washing sink at the location, okay? That you can build for less than $200. And I have the videos that show you that on my site. It's not hidden. It's we give you the basics on doing that. We even sell the sink insert so you can do the small hand washing sink, little faucet, a gas heater that later you can put in your trailer. Okay. So you won't waste any money by doing it because everything on there, except maybe the frame of the thing, which could be, you know, take the wheels off of it and set it on your trailer. And now you've got your hand washing sink in your trailer. But so you hadn't lost anything. So that's the sink thing solved. For those people that have more money, they can go to eBay. They sell these sink kits already done, ready to go. They ship them to you. They do a three bay, a four bay. They do a two bay and a one bay. And you can order, it comes to you already. Everything's set up. It's ready to go. You just add water and soap. But you'll see on my website, I give you all the parts to do it. It's not a big deal. It's an enclosed contained system. You asked about something else, Candace. I'm sorry.
Commissaries.
How do you find them?
Yeah.
This would be a long conversation, but if you go to learnhotdogs.com and in the search box type in the word commissary, it's going to give you more articles than you'll want to read. And I wouldn't read them all, because every time somebody asks about it, I post a new article about it if I've learned something new. But the first three or four will blow your mind. It'll give you plenty of power to do it. In my free training at the top of the page, it'll give you, I think it's video 4 that says, what is a commissary? In that video tells you how to get them. So you've got several things you can do there. Commissaries are easy to get without spending the money. It oftentimes scares people. They're like, oh man, I don't want to go ask somebody about that, you know, but it's really not as big a roadblock as people make it. It's more like a speed bump. And once you know the tricks to it, you just do these things and you'll have a commissary and you're done. You can even put in your own commissary here in Tennessee and Arkansas. I'm not positive what it requires to have one at your house. I just have a separate entrance and a floor mop, a mop sink. And now I've got a commissary.
Wow.
So you can call your health department. They may go, oh, you have, here's what we're going to require. You put a 3-bay sink in your, any room in the house. It can be in the kitchen or out in the garage. And you have to have a hand wash sink. So, you can build a 4-bay sink for $200 with everything. I'm talking with the heater, the pump, the battery, the jugs, the sinks, the whole works for right around $200. So you might could do your commissary yourself. Did you have any other questions for me?
No.
Okay. John asked about bonds. John, I don't know if you saw the show earlier today. I did. I answered this thoroughly. I went through bonds like mad and explained it. If you go down the page, you'll see it. The show, you came on, but I think you came on towards the end of the show. That will give you all the information on insurance and bonds. Shane says, I'm going to pop this up on the screen. Shane says, here in Southwest Missouri, you can use a spigot dispenser water cooler for a hand washing station with a bucket below to catch it. Easy peasy. So you might be that easy there. In Tennessee, guess what we don't have to have? We don't even have to have a sink. They say if you do not have a sink, you have to have sanitary hand wipes.
Wow.
So you need to, I'm going to send you this course and go through it, pick out what you want, or pick out some ideas you and Dale want to try or what interests you. If you have any questions, contact me and I'll help you.
All right. Thank you, Ben.
I've enjoyed this. I'm glad y'all came on, because I don't think I've ever interviewed anybody that wasn't vending yet. And so I hope that y'all come in and allow me to talk to you as y'all go through it, even in the bad stuff. That Absolutely. Way we can share it with everybody.
Absolutely, we will. Absolutely. Thank you.
Well, thank you. I hope that y'all have a fantastic evening. I know it's Friday evening. Dale, thanks for coming on.
Dan, I still didn't get your mother-in-law's name and number.
You'll borrow money from my mother-in-law? She'd probably do it. She's got a heart of gold. I got lucky with mother-in-laws.
Thank you so much, Ben.
Hey, thank y'all. I appreciate it. I'm going to, y'all, you're welcome to stay on here. I'm going to go over, I'm going to switch over to the other camera, and I'm going to pull up anybody that's got any questions. I'm happy to answer them. And let's see, we have, well, Corey's been answering people's questions, talking to them over here. So I hope that helps. John, if you need any more information on the bonds, let me know. I'll be happy to help you there. The David does 2 days a week, but does several yearly events. I'll pop that up real quick so everybody can see it. Hey, Candace, did you ever get your screen to work?
Never did. Still looking at a white screen.
That's boring. We can see you. Everybody can see you.
Wow.
Now, you can switch over now to Facebook, and it wouldn't matter. You'd be able to see it, and you'll be able to watch this.
Oh, okay.
But I thank you for coming on. William Joseph says he has a Stand King and loves it. Thank you, William. I appreciate that. The South Georgia, we don't have a down season. That's the truth. You don't really have a down season there. I've got family doing vending in Florida. They don't ever have a down season either. But we know vendors in Canada we've interviewed on the radio show, on Hot Dog Vendor Radio, who don't quit all year round. The only time they aren't vending is if it's storming or something crazy on the day they're supposed to work. Let's see. I appreciate all the kind comments and everything everybody added. I appreciate the fact that Candace and Dale came on and shared what's going on and were so honest about the stumbling blocks and everything. Hopefully all this will go good and we'll be able to follow their success. That'd be fun, wouldn't you think? So y'all have a wonderful day. I'm going to check out, and I think I'm going to go fix something to eat, maybe a hot dog or something. And I'm going to be putting out a video this weekend about my little secret sauce that I put on a dog that I've never told anybody about. It's stupid simple, but it works and it tastes good. We'll talk to y'all later. Y'all have a good one.
Thanks, Ben.
Thank you. Thank you, Dale.
Thank you.